Hi, Bruch Mavoy. I suspect that all of you feel the same excitement that I feel. I don't know about the Shmuess per se, but about being here in Yeshiva. Welcome you all back to the Kosei Beis HaMedrash. I can rightfully assume it's the recognition that all of you have, the Korach of Torah, the Chashivas of being together, the Chashivas of being as a group, the Chashivas of being in a central place of Libud. It enhances the quantity, quality, the kiruv levavos, pibul chaverim. Everything is different than yeshiva, and that's why we're here. So, you know, normally I think we always have a debate every year. You know, it's a summer zman, a different zman from Pesach, same zman. I think Kuyah will please. Definitely different zman this time. No shadow about it. Definitely different zman. It's an exciting time, a time when we have a chance to grow, an opportunity to, which you've all seized the moment. The next couple of weeks we'll be together with Hashem, the Shtai, to grow Asmada and Yerushalayim, Midos Tovos, and our appreciation of Kodesh Baruch Hu's the job is given us to grow, become Yerayim V'Shleima. Yishkayach for you guys. Yishkayach. I don't mean for the nachas that you give us, but just the fact that, you know, you have the appreciation of the recognition of this Chashiva. It's very special, meaningful to me, and it's a reality. It's such an exciting thing to hear that there's Talmid Matur, you can be out there, could go to, I don't know if you go to camp, I'm not sure about that, but you can go out there, get jobs, and be home, the luxuries at home, the beautiful meals at home, and your own schedule, no one's going to watch over you. Fakir's not going to hack you about coming to Minyan, or I'm not going to hack you about coming to Seder, but right? It's so nice out there, but it's not nice out there. It's nice in the coast, with your medics, and Shkar for joining us. I'm telling you, I'm just going over and over again because I'm very excited about it. I wish I could be with you guys all the time also, but Hashem has other plans. Anyway, Rabosai, that's just the first Shmuess, Rabosai, just talk about the power, the koach, what we're doing with the koach of Torah, how powerful Torah is. Plus, it talks about the machokas between Korach Adaso and Moshe Beinu, and Kodesh Baruch Hu. Moshe finally says to them, I don't know, Moshe Korach, Shimon Revi, I'm sorry, the question before, Rabochem Revi. Rashi, Dabar Gadol, it's famous Rashi, Dabar Gadol, Amarti Lachem, I told you something very special. You know, what's going on? Well, Tipshim Heim. They weren't Tipshim. Shikacha Tishu Bohem, Kibugu Aleim, Makariv, Elohim Chata Nashosa. Remember, there's a whole show with the Mies in the post, and the Rishonim, but that's not the point. Then Rashi, the Korach should be Kach Hayim, right? The third line of Rashi, Korach was a Bikach, he was a brilliant person, a smart person, Gadol, tremendous Talmud Chacham, Maru Oshtoseh. What kind of stupidity? How could he ever think about doing this? Right? I think there were 250 plus him, plus Moshe Rabbeinu rather. Right? So I think that's the odds of, and Moshe just told them that only one person come out alive, or the rest of us will perish. They have a chance of one in 251, I guess, it comes up. I got the question right. I think that's what it was, 250 plus Moshe Rabbeinu. They have a chance of one in 251 to come out alive. I would not give too much for those odds if my life's at stake. Right? So that's Rashi's kasha. Right? You have to be a shota. Okay, they had their own cheshmen, their chotan ha-shos, but Korach was bekeach, so how can you be so foolish and stupid to do something which the odds so far, so far against coming out alive? You know, he's one person, there's 250 out there, Moshe Ben on the other side also. Says the Rashi, Eino Hidas, I made a little mistake, Rosh HaShelos Kedola, the old team met, we saw a tremendous lineage coming out from him. Descendants Shmuel Shokke Moshe Aaron Shmuel was so great. Amar Bishvigo Ani Imla. Obviously, I'll be saved because Shmuel's going to come from me. That's from Arba Mishmaros, Ogus will make mud up and all the Mishmaros will also come. Kul Mishnabru Hatodesh Gedoe Dor, Shnemer Kahil Bana Mehemen. Amar Efshaka Lua Zos, I see the Rabbi Mimetical and my Adam. You think they all come and I'll be destroyed, I'll be forgotten about, I'll be quiet. That doesn't make sense. Of course, I'll survive. Therefore, he felt confident. Shasham Pimosha, Shakub Oakdom, Echanimwa. Right? So he thought, because obviously I'm going to be saved. Look who's coming from me. Ashir Hashem Kuah Kadosh, Tob and Tob Asma. So he made a little mistake. He thought he would be the one to be saved. Right? Because look at my descendants. Yosef, he made a mistake. He didn't see properly. Vishabana, Asu, Truva. His children, right? Mnei Karachal Mesu. Right, they stayed alive, they did tshuva, Moshe, Yeroa, Moshe saw. Moshe saw with clear vision, saw what it's going to be. He figured out, he saw that it was the children. But he himself, he made a mistake, right? He made a mistake with himself. The kasha both is, the obvious kasha is, how did Rashi answer his kasha? Right? He answered his kasha to larger people. The Maisa, right? The truth was, right? The reality was that Korach's children would stay alive, would do tshuva. How come Korach didn't think of that one? You know, unless I'm going to stay alive because of my descendants, what about the children? And that's what kachavik, that's what actually happened. So how come he couldn't figure that one out? That, okay, it's not 1 and 251 anymore. I don't know if he had 2 or 3, I don't know how many children he had, so it's 1 and 5, 1 and 10, whatever it was, but still, why would I think he assumed he would stay alive? Why should he assume that? Well, kind of a pretty foolish guy. You don't walk out of tightrope, you know, if there's a 1 in 2 chance you're going to die, right? It doesn't make sense. So I would still say, you know, Korach Pekeo Chaya, my Rosh Tazet. Terrence, I think, or Chad Rav one time said, I think Shad is that Shad Rabotai, because Korach was a very smart person, was a big Talmud Chacham. He analyzed so if he knew his kids pretty well. And he made a cheshbon. He figured, I know my kids are so much into this. They're really into this. I can't say rebellion, but into this into this situation, trying, they all feel that Moshe made a mistake. They're all willing to get up and stand against Moshe Rabbeinu. Korach was convinced that these people, seeing who they are and where they're holding, they'll never do tshuva. They'll never do tshuva. It's not for that. I know my kids are not tshuva. A smart man also. See, his cost of analysis and interpretation of where his kids were holding was such that he came to the obvious results, to him at least, that I'm going to be the ones to stay alive. My kids will never stay alive. They're not going to do tshuva, not going to change. LMI, they'll be killed. So if it's me or them, it's not going to stay alive. That's what he figured. It's because they'll never do tshuva, right? That's whatever eventually happened. It's not going to happen. He predicted that won't happen. Foresee the possible to such degree that he was confident to put his life into his own hands, take his life at, to risk his life, because he knew that he would be the one to stay alive. That's what Rashi is telling us. The most just think about it. It's mind-boggling. Well, Maisa did do tshuva. So why they do tshuva? Because they heard Moshe Rabbeinu, they saw that they sensed his amitus, they saw the power of Torah and how, you know, Moshe Rabbeinu was a person teaching pure Torah. And when a person's connected to Torah, a person connected to the Torah mitzvahs, Avodas Hashem, the special purity, special holiness, special, it helps, as Chazal tells us, as Mezakeh HaNefesh, purifies the soul. And let's see emes, let's see the truth. So Korach didn't understand, made a mistake. Right? He didn't realize how powerful Torah is. And he didn't realize, in spite of all the derech ha-teva, negative aspects and all the things which would not enable his kiss of the tshuva, he made a mistake. He underestimated the power of the hashpa, of the amitas ha-Torah coming from Moshe Rabbeinu's mouth, that would win out, and that would convince his children that you guys are wrong. Children are wrong, and Moshe Rabbeinu is the real one. You can tell there's a special koach that a person has to be receptive to the power of Torah, the power of mitzvahs, the power of ruach, the power of emes, the power of others, baruch hu, hashmara, both things. It's all there in the Torah. And Korach's kids saw that's what happened. That's how Korach's kids, against all odds, my old psychologist would predict that, I'll never do tshuva, it's not shayach. He was bekeach, Korach. But he said to himself, I'll never do tshuva. I know they won't do it. But that was without the recognition, without the depth of the hair of understanding of how powerful the cause of emes is, how powerful the purity is of Torah. And therefore, they eventually did tshuva because that got to them. But both of that should be a special inspiration to us, beginning this new span, coming down. But that's here, we're here for the Torah. The Torah has tremendous powers to change us, to enable us to see through that there's so much out there, so much shaking, so much filth out the world around the world. It's so hard to see proper Torah Hashgafa. The odds are against us. The odds are in terms of pure physical, psychological messias. So we can't. There's so much attracting us. There's so many beautiful things that attract us. Everything is out there on both sides. But we have the power of Torah, which is influencing us, which we're delving into, which we're harping on. Got the Masas Tamin. From Asriach and this, and absorbing Gastar, absorbing the Derech Hashkof and the Torah, both. That's the power we have, the power of the Torah has. And we can Masriach tremendously put ourselves into it. But that's in general, both. But a little more specifically, you know, we go ahead, we're Zocha to be back in the Yeshiva. Kai is supposed to be Zohan by and large to go back into the Bat Knesset, but in the Drush, but in the Midrash, and we earned it, hopefully. See, Hashem saw, hopefully we did our thing to recognize the faults we had and to machadik ourselves, especially referring to davening, a lot of aspects, but referring to davening, we didn't have the schus for a while to daven the minyan daven in the basic Knesset that we have now. We have to appreciate what it means, that the power, the schus that we have to daven, what we can accomplish through davening. The pasuk talks about as Moshe, after he hears that he invited Korach and his people to come, let's talk at Shmuess, let's talk about this. This is what you're doing. Korach said, "No way! If you blind us, we're still not going to come." Vayichal Moshe ma'ot. The pasuk tells us Moshe got very angry, and he tells Hashem, "Al tefen al minchasa, don't respond to their mincha." They never took anything, but they were also, but don't respond to their mincha. Says Rashi, "Ufim shuto." They're going to tomorrow bring a Torah to you. Don't respond to their mincha. Don't respond to the Torah. I'll pay for aleihem. The Ramban says a little more about what Ramban says. He doesn't like exactly Rashi of the Torah. Ramban's a little different. Ramban says, I'll shoot up. About two thirds away in the first column, I'll shoot up. Kibavur shahayu eila rotsim the chuda, the hacker korban. They want to be koinim. They want to bring korbanos for kayis, for our Moshe. Don't go ahead and respond to the korban shall bring. And to the tefillah shall daven to you. There's the minchasam which the pasuk is talking about, which Moshe ben Yisrael is referring to the korban of the tefillah. Tefillah is more than korban tefillah, the same idea. But Moshe was concerned that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, please, he begged Hashem, he bowed to Hashem, al tefen al minchasam, don't respond to the tefillahs, don't respond to the kabanos, and let's show them that Moshe Rabbeinu, I am the one that you chose, and my decisions, my appointments were appropriate, al pi Torah. Don't respond to them. And Moshe, I think it's the ultimate counsel, says, he says, what kind of havmida did Moshe have? He has davened to Hashem, please don't respond to him. To respond to who? To Korach. Korach was, firstly, it was wrong. But she was wrong, right? Moshe Rabbeinu was doing the right thing. All this stuff, all the people he pointed was himself, or Aaron, or himself, and Zeal, right? They were the right people he chose. Moshe didn't do anything wrong. So Korach makes the story. It's not Hashem, you did it on your own. Hashem, please don't listen to the tefillos. They're wrong, simply. And much more than that, Ultimate Kelm says, can you imagine what would have happened if Hashem would have listed the tefillos? So Hashem would have let Korach be charged, Moshe with Tarasa Emes out the window. Right? It would be a different Torah. It would be terribly drastically different. I don't know, but Hashem picked Moshe Rabbeinu because he was the one that was Roy Tigili. It was a proper manik, proper meat, it was a proper tzitzis, not so driven by covet and a drive to be in charge and power. That was the Torah. The Torah was a person driven by covet, and he wanted the power of being in charge of Kai Yisrael. It would have been a different Torah, but the whole of the generations from Moshe Rabbeinu until now would have been totally different. The Torah would have been different. It would have been a different manik, a different leader. It was with a cheshna, Hashem picked Moshe Rabbeinu. But Moshe Rabbeinu is afraid. You know what's going to happen? He'll daven, and it'll be Karbanos tomorrow, it'll be Karbanos later on, and you're going to listen to us too. Come on. Like, what's the thing? I'm so concerned about that. They'll never have a million years. They can't have, because it would be a drastically different Torah. What about Hashem's Torah? What about Hashem's master plan? Out the window. No more Moshe Rabbeinu, no more Moshe Rabbeinu, Taras and Emes. So what's going on? It'll be a different Torah, Korach's Torah. That's not what Hashem's plan was. And that would be obviously a different Torah, different people giving it over. A person who wants covenant, a person who wants power. That's what we want as a Manik Ador. Crazy. Says the ultimate calendar of both that you see, right? The ultimate Zebra the Fun, right? Zebra the Fun of both that you see. That there was a chance that Moshe Rabbeinu was concerned. The chance was there that if Korach would daven sufficiently, the Kabbalahs would be sufficiently strong in terms of, I guess, the Kabbalahs behind the properly done, the power of field can overpower, overcome all those concerns which I just mentioned, all those plans for Kadosh Baruch Hu, and enable Korach to be the leader. Hashem says, so Moshe Rabbeinu says, Hashem, please, listen to my tefillah, right? I entreat you, I'm begging you, please, don't listen to his tefillahs. I know you might, there's a chance you might do, because the power of field is so chashuv, so powerful. The person davens with all this kavana, all this might, all this intense feeling of hagashta, Baruch Hu, please answer my tefillos. It's so powerful, it could potentially change the whole master plan of Hashem. Baruch Hu, change the whole Torah's Moshe out the window, Torah's Korach, a different leader, different Who knows what will happen? I don't get to see that, but that's the power of the few on both sides. And finally, in the psukma at the bottom of the page, next week's parsha, Chukas, after the Meimariva, the Rohu says to Moshe Ben, famous lines, because you did not have enough trust in me, therefore you will not bring, I'm telling you right, you will not bring Kai Yisrael to Eretz Yisrael. Says Rashi, Lochein Osavio, Shvua. He swore, first bro, Lochein Osavio is a Shvua. It's not just, you're not going to do it, but I'm promising, I'm taking Shvua an oath right now. Lochein Shvati, leave the base daily. Nishba Bekfitz, he jumped up and he swore, like a very firm Shvua, Shoyiru Bekfitz Al Kach. He was afraid, Baruch was afraid that Moshe Benu, Moshe Aaron, would daven so much, have such a successful prayer, such a successful feel for Baruch, please allow us to overturn your rule and please change your mind, Hashem, let us into Eretz Yisrael, that he would listen to them, right? He would, you know, they would daven so much, and he would have to go ahead and respond to them. Therefore, Hashem says, no, I'm taking Yeshua. I take Yeshua, I'm untouchable. Sakdin is finished, you can't change it, can't be over in Shvua. Hashem swore to make sure it doesn't die. Rabosa, again, Rabosa, this is mind-boggling. I don't understand Rabosa, I don't understand. What was Hashem afraid? They'll die, they'll do tshuva, do everything, you know. Okay, so let's see. Hashem, when that happens, you go ahead, I don't think Hashem was impatient, I don't want them bugging me, I don't think it was concerned, they might daven and overturn the Xayr. I mean, if they daven, Kiroi, they do proper tshuva, they daven enough kavana, and it's appropriate, it's worth it to go ahead and overturn the Xer. So we're going to do it, right? Hashem's a person of emes and tzedek and yashus, right? If they're deserving to, the tshuva is appropriate, the tefillah is appropriate, so what's Hashem afraid about? Elamai is such a terrible avera, there's no way, they can never be allowed, they can never be roi, take Chai Yisrael into Eretz Yisrael. Okay, so that means they'll die, and they can't overturn it. What's he afraid of? He's afraid of emes coming through, they're afraid they'll do tshuva. They're entitled to go into Eretz Yisrael, so let them do it. They're not going to be entitled, so he has to swear, make sure they don't daven too much, and what's going to happen? Nothing will happen. Whatever happened, it will be fine. Hashem will judge the judge and not in the new situation as it's appropriate, right? What's he concerned about? The kasha, right? Eretz Yisrael, you see, again. Oh, well, see, the Marv tonight better be good after these Shmuess, but the Marv better be full of Kabbalah, because, like, this is unbelievable. But also, look at this. HaKadosh Baruch Hu was afraid that Moshe Rabbeinu would daven, such a davening, which Al Pi Derech, normal Hilchos rules of tshuva and charata and pleading and all that, it's not going to work. It's not, you can't overcome and over outweigh the terrible avil of Yan Lomantin. It doesn't match up with such a terrible affair. Nothing can do it. Nothing. It feels should not be able to. However, there's a special, I don't know what you want to call it, maybe a special, a special bonus. I'm not sure what it's called exactly. There's a special Korach field, which doesn't make any sense. So he broke him a special, I don't know what you call it, bonus, I don't know what you call it, special injection of power, which it shouldn't have. It should have because it's steel, but I'll be normal Hilchot, you know, Chub and Hilchot, you know, Karat and Hilchot, you know, are you deserving? You're not deserving, right? The fact you elevate yourself in such a Munah Bashem, you know, it doesn't make sense. It shouldn't overcome the Aver, which you did. And you shouldn't be allowed to go into Eretz Yisrael, but Hashem's hands will be tied because the power of Tila, Hashem gives that power of Tila. When you go to Hashem with sincerity, it's worth twice as much, three times, five times as much as it's really worth helping. When you measure everything else, all the other mitzvahs and Talmud Torah and Leibniz, whatever it is, it should have a certain value. And that's because that's what it, the value is commensurate to the person's growth, how much a person most nefesh, how much a person believes in Hashem, all the above. But there's something special about tefillah that when you do tefillah, when a person focuses and does whatever he can about tefillah, it's like the nimbashur to them. I can't even explain it. I'm not sure if I can explain it properly, but that's the cost of tefillah. I saw Moshe, Hashem was afraid that they daven with all their perfection and davening. They're humbling themselves to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And Hashem will say, you know, they really shouldn't leave Kai Yisrael. It's not according to all the rules of Hilchus, you know, judgment and Hilchus Tshuva and Hilchus Beis Hashem. It doesn't make sense. But maybe Hashem has special love for Tzio so much that he gave him a special koach that he has to respond. Hashem felt I have to go ahead and swear, so that once I swear, nothing I can do. You can't stand up against the brick wall. Nothing you can do anymore. Rabosai, please, just mechazi yourself and appreciate how much you can accomplish with your davening. Results that come back into the basic medicine, basic nesses, and shuls of minion, and how valuable it is. And Hashem does not, no tefillah ends up being not listened to. Hashem does not leave any tefillah breakup. It's always answered, sometimes not right away, sometimes not as a person who wanted it to happen. If you want this, Hashem gives this, but tefillah is so valuable beyond what Abdullah should be. It doesn't make any sense. And it can overturn, it helped Korach. With all the riches and all this, trying to change Torah's Moshe and get rid of Moshe Rabbeinu can help him do that, because that's the power of fewer of those things. So we have to appreciate the cause of Torah, which we're being exposed to now, and we learn and sit with our chavrusas and we hear shurim and we daven. The cause of Torah is so powerful, how much of an impression you have upon us, number one, and number two, about side. On a more specific level, right, focus, there's so much cause of fewer. A person puts enough into it and has the proper kavanah, the proper humility. Proper condition of HaKadosh Baruch Hu being in charge. He does that, he exhibits the HaKadosh Baruch Hu proper feeling. There's no limit to how much power, how much koch can have. Shkoyach.